Hello, my name is Julio Marco and I'm going to present our work Virtually Transform Matrices for Nonlinear-State Imaging. Nonlinear-State Imaging methods aim to recover information from scenes that are not directly visible to an observer. The typical setup consists of a target scene, hidden behind an occluder, and a surface visible to the observer. To recover information about the hidden scene, ELLO's methods analyze the indirect illumination at the visible surface produced by the hidden objects. In particular, active light and loss methods simultaneously illuminate a visible relay surface and measure the resulting indirect illumination from the hidden scene at picosecond resolution. Time-resolved indirect illumination reveals information about the hidden scene that is usually lost in a regular steady state image. Thanks to these measurements, these methods can reconstruct scenes with challenging transport effects, such as surfaces with complex reflectors properties, micron-scale geometry, or clutter scenarios with occlusions and interreflections. Currently, ELLO's imaging is mainly focused at reconstructing the geometry behind a corner. However, given the variety of light transport effects that may take place, our goal is to provide a method for general understanding of light transport in hidden scenes. To enable this general understanding, we propose a framework to compute and analyze light transport in ELLO's configurations. In order to achieve this, our work combines two key components: recent ELLO's methods based on phasor fields, which create virtual lights and cameras faced towards the hidden scene, and traditional computation of light transport matrices of line-of-sight scenes, which encode global light transport between light sources and cameras. Phasor fields methods have recently opened a new ELLO's imaging paradigm that turns the relay wall into a virtual lens that observes the hidden scene. This is done by using specific imaging functions that transform real measurements into a field of complex phasors that can be focused at specific planes. This allows to create virtual imaging devices that observe the hidden scene from a line-of-sight perspective and take pictures of it. With the ability to create virtual cameras and light sources, we propose to compute light transport matrices in hidden scenes to provide general understanding of these. The light transport equation defines the linear relationship between a set of light sources and a set of measurements by means of the light transport matrix. This matrix encodes the global light transport effects of the scene for each light source and each measurement, and is typically unknown. Efficient estimation of this light transport matrix has enabled a wide variety of fundamental applications for scene understanding, such as separation of direct and global illumination, or more complex matrix probing operations that enable de-scattering, separation of specific ranges of illumination, or masking certain light paths between objects. These methods typically estimate the light transfer matrix using projector camera setups with aligned pixel arrays that simultaneously illuminate and capture the visible scene. In the resulting LTM, columns represent projector pixels and rows represent camera pixels. Similar to line-of-sight settings, our goal is to estimate light transfer matrices in ELLO's configurations to provide general understanding of hidden scenes. To achieve this, we couple recent phasor field imaging with the traditional LTM formulation and create virtual projector camera setups in ELLO's scenes to estimate the virtual LTM of hidden scenes. Under this setup, we estimate the LTM of a voxel-less hidden scene by systematically illuminating different voxels with a virtual projector and capturing the scene response with a virtual camera. Let's now have a closer look at how we compute different elements of the LTM. Under co-located projector and camera pixels, each diagonal element of the LTM corresponds to focusing projector and camera at the same location in the scene. This focusing requires shifting the phasors at each laser and path coordinate by the corresponding distances to the voxel XB in the scene. Since the diagonal elements result from focusing illumination and camera onto the same voxel, the resulting magnitude corresponds mainly to the direct light at the voxel location. Off-diagonal elements, in turn, focus illumination and image at different locations of the scene. Here, XA represents the illuminated location and XB the image location. Projector focusing requires shifting phasors on the laser domain with respect to the distance to the illuminated voxel XA. In contrast, camera focusing requires a phase shift in the domain of SPAD locations, but with respect to the image voxel XB. Since the off-diagonal elements focus illumination and camera onto different locations, the resulting magnitude corresponds to indirect illumination cast by the illuminated location XA to the image location XB. While these operations effectively focus illumination at different locations of the scene, the endless setting poses a fundamental challenge different from real projector camera setups. The size of the virtual aperture of both projector and camera corresponds to the area captured in the relay wall, which is typically very large. In consequence, the virtual lenses have a very shallow depth of field, and the LTM elements are prone to contain significant autofocus illumination if the lens is not focused at a geometry location. This defocusing happens for both projector and camera lenses. To mitigate these autofocus effects when computing the LTM, we propose a set of gating functions that operate in the temporal domain when propagating light at different voxels. To remove autofocus light from diagonal elements, we gate the signal at single bounce paths from the laser locations to the voxel V, XV, and back to the SPAD location. Off-diagonal elements contain light paths of at least two bounces. If either projector or camera focus on an empty voxel, propagation will introduce autofocus illumination. While gating two bounce paths can mitigate this effect, there may be autofocus paths with the same gating length, as shown on the left diagram for point XA prime. To solve this problem, we propose to use the diagonal of the LTM as an oracle of geometry locations. This way, when computing off-diagonal elements, we can choose to focus projector and camera lenses only at non-empty locations of the hidden space. Combined with two-bounce temporal gating during propagation, our off-diagonal elements represent in-focus first-order indirect illumination. We now illustrate the results of our endless LTM computation methodology. We show the effects of diagonal computation in a complex office scenario, including single bounce gating, which produces a very clean estimation of the direct illumination. If no gating is applied during light propagation, the resulting image is flooded with geometry autofocus. We now illustrate how our off-diagonal computation shows changes of indirect illumination over a mannequin when changing the material of our reflector. The blue mark represents the illuminated location on the reflector. When the reflector specularity is low, the mannequin shows indirect light over the entire torso, head, and legs. When increasing the reflector specularity, it concentrates the indirect light towards the torso of the mannequin. We now show how specific columns of the LTM show indirect light at a highly cluttered scenario, coming from the center of the lamps A, B, and C separately in the ceiling of the room. Every column in the LTM corresponds to a different location on the lamps. We can see how the profile of the indirect illumination changes as we move the illuminated point from one lamp to the other. By masking different distances from the LTM diagonal, we can isolate indirect light within a specific path length when illuminating the three points simultaneously. As we move away from the diagonal, we can see the changes in the resulting indirect illumination. Finally, we demonstrate LTM computations in real endless scenes. The resulting diagonal computation yields the direct component of the hidden scene. While point-to-point focusing requires combining 2D arrays of both SPADs and lasers, available 1D SPAD arrays are also compatible under our framework. This yields simpler LTMs where the projector illuminates 1D vertical lines instead of single points, resulting in a vertical slice of the patch bouncing in direct light over the mannequin. To summarize, we define a framework that couples the LTM formulation with endless forward propagation. We provide the specific imaging and gating functions for different elements of the LTM under the phasor field framework, addressing large aperture issues from endless setups. We demonstrate how this serves to probe virtual LTM to separate light components and specific illumination path lengths. We hope our framework to benefit from existing line-of-sight techniques for LTM analysis and apply them to the endless regime. We also hope that it will help understanding hidden scenes with more complex effects such as foveing environments, or even to handle configurations with objects behind more than one corner. I will be happy to discuss any questions you may have. Thanks for your attention.